Baryon number is necessarily violated in any grand unified theory, GUT. In the SU5 GUT, nucleons decay via the exchange of gauge bosons with GUT scale masses. The dominant decay mode of the proton is into a positron and a neutral pion. In any simple gauge symmetry, with one universal GUT coupling and scale, the nucleon lifetime from gauge exchange is calculable. Hence, the GUT scale may be directly observed via the extremely rare decay of the nucleon. In non-SUSY GUTs, the GUT scale is of the order of 10 to the 13th to 15th GeV. The dimension 6 baryon violating operators mediate nucleon decay with the lifetime less than 10 to the 32nd years. This is ruled out by the present bounds from Super-Kamiokande, greater than 10 to the 34th years. The fermion representations are shown on the left. The adjoint, gauge bosons, is shown on the right, where we have only written down the X and Y part. X, Y are the new gauge bosons that have appeared in the SU5 GUT. They convert quarks to leptons and vice versa. The fact that the diagrams of the process proton decays into a positron and a neutral pion are easy to draw means that, if the proton actually decays, those diagrams are most likely the dominant processes. This is one of the conspicuous characteristics of the SU5 GUT. The SO10 GUT contains a 16-dimensional spinor representation. All the 16 fermions, including a right-handed singlet neutrino, can be contained in a single representation with the right quantum number. The SO10 GUT provides more than one route to break the symmetry and an extra handle which can be used to adjust the evolution of the running coupling constant minutely. For instance, it is possible to have the three constants meet together and to reproduce the observed Weinberg angle as well as the proton decay rate. The SO10 GUT has many attractive features not provided by other models and is one among the favorites of many theorists in discussing the GUT model.